And Sam, in terms of lighting on set, so let's say I've got a volume that's, as we described it, like a four-walled kind of LED volume. You mentioned already that your system facilitates having traditional lighting intermixed with that. But if I leave that traditional lighting off for a second, you can also use the LED walls as a new form of lighting. Like you could put up a white card on the LED screen, it would act like an area light. How much is that something that DOPs are embracing, or do you find that still a bit less explored in terms of implementation?
Well, this is a very powerful director of photography tool, because a lot of reasons why traditional visual effects don't look great is because the DP couldn't see the composite. I can adjust any of us on green screen if I can see exactly what I'm going to get here. I know exactly how much light to put through. LED screens are very bright, and they do a lovely job at ambient fill. LEDs do not put out hard light. They don't put out hard shadows. So in fact, we are projecting light with projectors to get hard cut ambient, sunlight coming through these windows. And the other thing, anybody who's been in compositing at all, if you're doing a green screen comp, you get the background to look perfect, and then you adjust the foreground separately from the background. You get just the right amount of black contamination atmosphere in those trees to give them just the right amount of depth, and then you adjust me separately. We're doing the same thing on set. We're getting the perfect exposure on the screen, the perfect tracking on the screen that we want, and then we can adjust the lighting, which is linked to the background. You're getting a certain amount of ambient, but you can also pick up a hard backlight on me and have sunlight come through the window, kinetic light. I believe that's one of the big misnomers of these big LED volumes, is everybody's saying, hey, we don't even have an electrical department anymore. We don't need any lighting. We can just walk on and it's going to be magic, right? Well, it's not going to be magic. And in fact, there are a lot of LED volumes being built that have no truss and no ability to hang a light from the rafters, right? How do you, a DP walks into that and says, where am I going to put my lighting, right? So we're not taking tools away. Again, if you're going to do a game show or a news show, fantastic. It's going to be the same lighting every week. You can set it up. But a dramatic show, every setup is different. Every lighting setup is different depending on the actress and her age. And, if you have zombies, then you light them differently than you light a, 16-year-old girl. I mean, it's just, it's just not one.
This is the kind of, stuff that I feel like when green screen came in, we started losing. These sets got smaller and smaller. And it's like, what does the set decorator and the DP do at that point? Which is unfortunate, because I know many DPs that are just, Most people are absolutely brilliant.
And let's keep in mind that I've been around long enough to go from film to color video taps were like a shock, because the DPs thought, oh my God, people are going to be judging our color. And then digital came in, and this should be an empowering technology, the way it's developed, to empower people rather than take away who they are. And I've had DPs come up to me on set and say, well, why should I worry about the lighting on green screen? Because you guys are going to change it all anyway, right? And that's like, no. And that's because it's a post process. If it's real time and you say, do you like what you see on the monitor? Right? And they go, oh, and then, we need more backlight. Okay, well, then go do it, right?
Well, you must also say it with the actors, right? The actors just being given a bit more to work with.
Oh, the actors, when the actors have eye lines and they can see it, on Run, we spent 12 weeks on a train in a silver tube, and if that was green screen, I think everybody would have been, in the hospital. But it's real time. You're looking, you see it. It's easier on the actors, way easier to block your scenes. The DP can light it. all the producers at Video Village can sleep at night because they've been looking at images that look great rather than a green screen with some guy saying, trust me, it's going to look great in a month.
You know? And some people will say, but what if there's a person standing in front of LED screen and it's not photoreal? Put a green box around them. Your human is lit.
Yeah.
You have real lighting. That same set with the proper preparation is going to be used by VFX. And because of Unreal now offering photorealistic lighting, then you will have accurate lighting that you know that V-Ray could replicate, Render Man could replicate. So then you could go and use
it. That's a really good point, Felix. There's actually shows that are working with that process in mind because they know some of these assets aren't going to be ready, but they're fantastical worlds and they really need believable lighting on the actors in the set. And so they're okay with something that's close but not final because it's going to get them so much further along. And Sam, as you mentioned, that is not trivial, making those changes on the actor in the physical set and post with all that comedy to get it to look right.
Yeah, I mean, if you don't like what you see is what you get on set. Now, if you're on green screen, you can put it off and make all sorts of decisions later. So that's why I'm saying if the director knows what he wants, you've had enough time to prepare the materials, you've tested things, and you've already proven it so that by the time you get on set, like what we did with the Akira test, you know what you're going to get. It's fantastic. But if the studio's not behind it and the director doesn't know what they want and maybe we want to change this or that, you definitely are better off on green screen. However, the business model is, you know, it's cheap to put up a green rag and shoot, right? It's really easy, you know, and you spend your money in post. It's pretty expensive to get a 100-foot LED wall out there with all the technology to run it and all these fabulous pre-biz tools and things. That's a lot of pre-production expenses, and the producer will look at you and create like, you're crazy if you say, well, we're going to spend all this money in prep and we're going to spend all this money on set and then we're going to throw all that out and you're going to spend just as much money in post. I mean, some people can afford to do that, but most shows that we've dealt with cannot afford that. So there is a financial equation to this. We need to be responsible to be able to say, this is the wisest way to spend the money. And you can have fantastic previs. You can have, you know, pre-comps on set or finished material on set, but don't throw away your post money because you're going to use it.